Hello, Busy. How's it going? Right now, I'm working on a concept for a race that I'm creating for a card game I'm working on. I did all like the his figure work, and then today I was messing with his face and then messing with color. And so now I'm basically multiplied him by three, so I can doodle some clothing on him to see how things will work out that way. That's pretty much the gist of it so far. Yeah, for some reason I can't get it to work. Are you able to hear me now? This is awful. Gonna turn down my. There we go. Hopefully that's better. Okay, cool. Yeah, I'm running this as well as Twitch, so trying to get all the programs to work the way you want them to can be kind of difficult sometimes. This guy's lore behind him is a little crazy, so, well, this race, I should say. They're kind of aristocratic, I want to say, but they live in an area that has a lot of tall towers. Yeah, it does. Do you do artwork here as well, or do you just browse? Trying to see if like I can get different types of pants. This reminds me of like Jedi. Like the wrapped pants and feet and stuff. I don't know what I'm going with this. Yeah, I usually put in about an hour a day where I'm sitting here streaming. But I got sick the past couple weeks. My boyfriend got some kind of flu, and then he passed that on to me, and then I had it. So the fact that I also play video games probably doesn't help either. I've been looking at Black Desert. Yeah, it does. Yeah, I'm feeling better now, which is good. Let's see. This one, I want him to have gloves. But yeah, so these guys are like wheeling and dealing merchants. They can talk their way out of a lot of things, and they're the actual... I actually designed these guys off of a couple different animals, one being my chinchillas I had a long time ago, because the way the feet work, when they sit down, that's actually their platform, and then their leg folds, so they can actually sit a little funny, but because they live in like these really tall towers that they climb up, and that's probably the best way for them to do that. So they have like, you know, they don't really have chairs. They just kind of sit around like Japanese, around a table. I think this one. Do something a little bit more with like straps. Little booties. I don't like the booties. Yeah, basically, because my chinchillas, they would sleep on like hardwood surfaces, because I used to cut out their homes out of wood, and then they'd sleep on ledges, and they would, that's how they slept, is they kind of would curl over, and then that was that thick part of the leg. And then there was this big long foot. So this is basically how they would sleep too. You know, is they'd either sleep like that or they'd sleep maybe up a little bit more, where they would hold their hands like such. And then but yeah, so those are like the two sleeping formations. But it allowed them to really be able to climb on anything, which is what I really wanted the race to be able to do. Because their cities are like platforms and then really tall poles that kind of go up to the next platform, so it allows them to really like plant their leg and grab around the poles and stuff. Yeah. I no longer have chinchillas because their hair got everywhere, and the volcanic dust, it turns out I was allergic to, so I had to let them go. So now I have guinea pigs. But I actually been doing a lot of research on sugar gliders. I guess I have a thing for like exotic marsupial animals, but I think my next based race is gonna be slightly off of them, their color patterns, their face shapes, and their tail and stuff. But yeah, after I finish it, at least get this guy started here. I actually have to go within like maybe a half an hour. I've got to go pick up the boyfriend from school, then I'll be back and might do some more work, but we'll see. That looks okay. Just say that there's a strap that comes up here. This is kind of like a sandal, maybe. This is like a shoe. That's just dirty. I'm not digging the Jedi thing anymore compared to these two. I like these shapes better. Not so much that. It seems like this has been overdone, maybe. We'll see. And this is the male. The females are gonna have like a little bit longer of, I mean, these guys have a long neck, you just can't see them. But the females are gonna have like a really long neck, and they're always gonna have really long hair to kind of go with it. But in those eyes, I might have them wear like a constant mask or something to cover their mouth so nobody really knows what their mouths look like. It would be kind of funny. Where the guys just have like all these crazy beards that flow. Excuse me. I thought I heard something, but that's weird. Oh, there we go. That's why. But yeah, I do plan on in the future, if people like it, I'm gonna set up a game Vox server so people can actually come and do voice chat with me so they don't have to type, because sometimes I think that's kind of silly. Then they can come and go as they please. I think that'd be kind of neat. Because sometimes I wish I didn't have to like
type out everything I'm thinking of, you know, when it comes to talking to artists. But for some people, it's okay. Oops, I don't want that to be the same color as the background. That would be very bad. Trying to mix a color that's a little bit darker, but not so crazy dark that you can't. It's not going to show well. Oops. I just want to make sure I wasn't breaking, because holy smokes, I'm still getting used to all these programs. No worries, though. I wish I can get my music to work on here, because that's like the best part. Well, maybe not the best part, but... Oh no, it's fine. I don't expect people to tell me what they're doing. It'd be kind of like, you can't watch my stream and be doing other things at the same time. That's not okay. I mean, who does that? It's not looking enough like cloth. If I break up the shapes a little bit more. Whoops. Then maybe. It's funny, like I went to UMass Dartmouth, and you just get used to talking while you do stuff, or you're listening to music while doing it, one of the two. Cloth, honestly, the more you break it up into different forms, the better it looks. Like, for example, this looks like leather to me, but if we took it and started breaking it down, like putting lines in it, it'll start looking like cloth. Watch. Of course, I'm not hitting. I have to remember that the highlights on this side are going to be a little bit brighter, only because it's actually hitting the light. But see, now it looks a little bit more like he's wearing a bed sheet. All because you broke it up. It's all, when it comes to cloth, it's all about the folds that you put in it. That's basically all you do. And then there's the whole. Yes, that too. And you have all your textures and things you have to worry about as well. Yes, lumpy cloth is a good cloth. Yeah, I actually helped out some other gaming companies in my past and learned a lot through the people I worked with. Fortunately, the game itself didn't have a lot of direction, so I ended up leaving and doing my own thing, hence this. But yeah, you learn a lot from other people, so I'm always like, I can give the information, I'll do it. I try not to be as fake as possible. I've met some pretty fake streamers where they promise all these things and they get you really psyched, but they really only pay attention to like someone who can get them higher up or someone that can get them an interview, and I think that's just silly. It's all about the people. People and connections, that's for sure. Looks like he's wearing saran wrap. Oh, God. Exactly. Yeah, I don't. I mean, I do this for definitely for the publicity because it's very hard getting anywhere as an artist unless people are able to see your stuff. But I'm not on here to become a partner of Twitch and make my living that way. I'm on here just to see who's out there, make some connections, and see what happens. That's where I kind of want things to be. That's how I think things should be too. Kind of reminds me of like those old time cartoon movies where the lady on the stage is all presentable and loves everybody, and then as soon as she gets behind the curtain, she can't stand anybody, and she's a jerk. Let's call her a jerk. But yeah. Let's see here. Start doing the leg pieces. I want these to be pretty darn tight. I drew them in pretty loose, which I probably shouldn't have. Probably going to put some light on this side. It's a little bit. My hand also gets really tired too. Like it starts hurting and it's not fun. I think it's because of how much pressure I put on the actual pen itself. See, it's pretty much all about breaking those shapes down. Anything really with artwork, if you can break the shape apart to understand how it fits with itself or with other things, you can pretty much do anything. Because that's all it really is. Like all these people that are like, oh, you have to get the reflective lighting and all of that, da, da, da. It's like, really, it's just stuff broken down into shapes. As long as you can get that going the right direction, you're good. Tighter, 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 tighter. There we go. I don't like this area. Just gonna blend that together. Doesn't look so awful. Oops. Oops. Who did that? Wish I could see. Shirama J1990, thanks for following. I didn't even see you on. But yeah, if you ever are on Twitch, my name on there is Blarklark for people who are in Watch Me Work. I'm not trying to take people away, it's just. That's the other thing, is breaking things down into shapes as well as big shapes too. I know that whole area I want to be darker. So it goes back in space a bit, but I don't want to make it black. It's the worst thing to do. And then I can kind of take some of the stuff and touch up. Kind of want to add some drapery behind this guy because he has so much cloth, it doesn't make sense why he wouldn't have that. It's like a shoulder cape thing. I could totally see him, on like a pole or something with that flapping in the wind. Yeah, Tuss, that too. I was thinking he was looking a little bit too like simpleton. You know? The lighting is coming from his back. Just deal with it like that for now. I'm not sure if I even like it. We'll see. The other thing to know is like which direction cloth usually folds when it comes to different parts of the body. Like a lot of times when you're working with legs, folds usually start from here and then go out by the way that the legs work because of how they're circular. I didn't mean to be erasing that whole time. The thing I'm realizing is that this part of his leg is going to be in the dark. So the lights are not going to be as light as they are. They need to be a little bit on the darker side. close to his color. Let's try. Kind of want to keep it warm tones. Yeah, I was thinking something like just touching a little bit with these, so not so dark. Very true that. Guess it depends on the setting though too. I feel like that's too much color. I like the red though. Just not on everything. Come back and play with this. Not sure if I'm quite satisfied with the shape of what he has on. Anyways, I will be back. I have to go pick somebody up. I'll most likely see you later. Where are they?